Tesla has rolled out its newest electric car. It's the Model Y, and CEO Elon Musk says it has the functionality of an SUV, but it rides like a sports car. It also comes with a pretty big price tag, the most expensive version topping 60 grand. Yahoo Finance's Rick Newman is here now. So, Rick, lots of Tesla news in the past couple of weeks. Who are they targeting with this Model Y?
I guess they're targeting people who have the money to buy it but want a crossover rather than a sedan. So it's actually quite similar to the Model 3. It has about 75% of the components it has in common with the Model 3, and that makes sense. That's how you scale a chassis and all the investment into one design. But look, people want crossovers these days really more than sedans. I mean, there's actually been this abrupt shift away from passenger sedans in favor of crossovers, which ride like cars but are just a little bit higher. And I would point out, Dan Roberts, our own Dan Roberts, keeps saying to me, it's not an SUV, it's something else. And he's really right about that. Tesla's calling it an SUV, but SUV implies more rugged capability than this is probably going to have. It implies off-road capability. It implies a ride height that can go off-road and handle the obstacles, which I don't think this vehicle is going to do. So I think it's fair to call it a crossover.
But it has more room than the 3.
Yeah, it's bigger.
You saw on that
graphic. That's right. It's a little bit longer.
You can seat 7 people in the Model Y versus 5 in the 3.
That's optional.
So
you can get an optional third row seat. It's probably going to be pretty tight because it is bigger than the Model 3. It's not that much bigger.
Yeah, I can't really see seven average.
Well, that's a good thing
if you have
small kids.
Yeah, that you're right. Until they grow up, and then you have to do something with your car. Do you think that it's worth the price?
Who knows? I mean, I think people will buy it. But I think by the time this comes onto the market, and they're saying they'll start making this in late 2020, but it probably won't really be available until 2021. And by the way, Tesla always slips on its timelines. There are going to be a lot of other compelling crossovers in the market in the luxury segment, including some electric ones. There's already a Jaguar out there. There will be an Audi out there by now. BMW, Mercedes, everybody is working on electric technology. And these, the big automakers have the ability to scale this. And when the time comes, flood the market with different models. And Tesla, to some extent, is still a one-trick pony.